Hi, welcome back. Emma's back in the studio. Emma Matacola, good morning.
Good morning, Megan.
It's finals day. We've seen round 9 of VFS. We've seen round 9 of the Formation Skydiving Female and the Open. And we're going into the Junior Freestyle Compulsory round 2.
Yes, we are. Yeah. Followed by the Freestyle Open.
Here we are.
No, round 3.
Round 3?
Round 3.
Yeah.
Compulsory two.
Compulsory two, yes, compulsory two. Do we know what we're doing? Do we know what the draw is?
Yes, they are. So we are doing Thomas Flair,
yep.
Barrel roll stall, and then head up breaker. But the performers can do it in any order that they choose.
Right, well, we saw the last bit of freestyle yesterday evening with our first look at the three rounds, and what an emotional, entertaining, sublime group of free flyers we had in the tunnel. It was beautiful.
Yes, we did. We saw some very emotive performances, some stunning performances. Kaylee Wittenberg, Fred Fernandez shocked and surprised and entertained us all. Elena.
Yeah, and we had the Singapore, all this new talent coming through from China, which just took us by surprise.
Absolutely. That routine was beautiful.
It was, yeah. Elena from here, of course, the Russian, yep. The Bolshoi Ballet, and there's so many. We'll be coming and reviewing them all as we go through the day. But who's going to be starting us off this morning in the junior compulsory?
Starting us off in the juniors, we're going to have James Rogers followed by Emily King. So two ones that we've been really enjoying watching. So let's get started.
Yeah, well, James stepped up yesterday and joined in with Sydney Kennett, taking over from Malachi, who was sick yesterday. I think he's a bit better. I was just having a little chat with him behind the studio, and he's got a little smile on his face. Still looks a bit grey, but I think he's good to go.
I think he's good to go as well, Regan. He's pulling it out of the bag. He's focusing on purely his freestyle. James has stepped in for the two-way dynamic, and they're now a guest team, Fly the Stash. But it's been really fun to watch, and Malachi's routine is amazing.
So we got the junior compulsory free round, and then the open freestyle compulsories, and then we're going into the VFS final. That's going to be with our live judging, and then we're going into the formation skydiving finals as well, with the open, the females too. That's going to be intense. We've not seen that before. And then we're into the quarterfinals of two-way dynamic with me and Emma Matacola. But right now, the action is on the compulsory freestyle and USA, James Rogers.
So these competitors, these junior freestylers, have 1 minute to perform 3 compulsory moves. As we said earlier, those 3 compulsory moves are Thomas Flair, barrel roll stall, and head up breaker. And he's straight into that Thomas Flair. So they can choose to link their moves any way they would like. We've just seen the barrel stall, I think. Let's watch. Here is the head up breaker. Very nice, looking very clean. This is James Rogers of the USA, age 14. Lots of support for James, and he's out. Very flowing, very well linked. Very well executed. A very exciting young flyer from James Rogers.
And a nice round of applause from the audience watching here at the tunnel. It's Saturday morning. It's a bit overcast skies out there. Bit dull. That means we get quite a few of the Skydiving Pure Brava staff have a special treat. They can come in here and have a coffee and watch the action. Next up for United Kingdom, a lot of big fan clubs for this girl, Emily King, Emma.
There is so much support for Emily here in the tunnel. There's so much support for her back home at her home tunnel of I Fly Basingstoke in England. Emily just looks so calm. I spoke to Emily's dad this morning and her coach, Zach. Zach was saying that she gets very, very excited when it's time for her turn to fly.
On the live stream, Emma Bagnall says, morning, Spain. Good luck, Emily. You've been great. Caroline Teal says, go, Emily. Everybody's watching. She's in.
She just grows in confidence every time I see her fly. There is the head-up breaker. So we can see already these two flyers are choosing to put their moves in different orders into the Thomas Flair. Come on. Emily keeping it smooth. Sounds like the wind speed has died off there. Very nicely done. Really well done, Emily.
Not quite sure what happened. She's shrugging her shoulders. What do you think happened there? We're just looking at a shot of the panel. It looks like a little technical problem there.
It does. And there was not enough time for the compulsory to be completed. So that will be a bit confusing for Emily, but I'm sure she'll take it in a stride and we will find out what has happened.
That's really interesting. I don't think I've seen that before. I wonder if she'll get a reflight, Emma.
I'm assuming she will, Regan, as it is a sort of technical difficulty.
Great job from the production team getting that camera shot straight
into there. Absolutely. Yes, it really was.
So, Emma, it's day three. It's not often we do an event which goes over 3 days.
No, but isn't it a fantastic one, Regan?
Yeah, we could do this for a week, couldn't we?
We could. We'd be quite tired by the end, but we love what we do.
So we're just watching now some briefing going on, Emma.
So Coach Zach Nicholas has come into the tunnel, is just explaining to Emily what has happened. Only 10 years old. It's going to be quite confusing for her, but you know what? She just takes everything in a stride. Little bit of a brief here. It looks like she will have to fly again, but she'll probably enjoy it, Regan. More time in that wind tunnel that she loves.
I think so. Look how big she looks next to our little...
Next to Kai.
Yes.
So, Emily, and then it will be Kai Minajima Lee flying up next. This is compulsory 2, which is round 3 of the junior freestyle. Seeing those competitors interacting is just so lovely.
Lisa Comber says, good luck, Emily. Chanel Pierce says, go, Emily. Smash it. She's got a worldwide fan club tuning into the live stream right here, right now. Finals day, day 3 of the Win Games 2019.
So it's a bit of a nervous wait for Emily in the chamber there as we wait to see what's going to happen. We're assuming it's going to be a reflight. So now Emily has time to just visualize, think about what she's going to do, get back in and do another beautiful job. She managed to get most of the way through her compulsory. So to remind you, the 3 moves that we are looking for in any order are Thomas Flair, Barrel Roll Stall and Head Up Breaker. Just a shot of the driver there who is sorting out what's going to happen with the tunnel, what will happen with the wind. So, Regan, should we take a little look at some of the scores from yesterday?
Yeah, tell us what was going on there, Emma.
So, if we have a little look at the top 5 in the junior freestyle, which is the category that we are looking at now, in 5th place from Singapore, we've got Isabel Koh. In 4th place from the USA, we have Sydney Kennett. 3rd place, also from the USA, we've got James Rogers. 2nd place, we've got Malachi Diaf from Canada. And up in 1st place, it looks like 0.3 of a lead, it is Kinga Bala from Poland.
Thanks very much, Emma. As well as the competition going on here today, we've also got other aspects of what Windor are doing, as well as finding the champions in the airflow. We're looking for the champions amongst the community as well, with a fundraising initiative for the first time here at Wing Games. Let's have a look. And a very warm welcome back to the Red Bull studio here in Ampuria Brava, Spain. Emma Matacola, Regan Tetlow, we are ready to bring you a full day of action here at the Wing Games 2019 into day three, finals day. If you don't know where we are, we're in the northeast corner of Spain. It's an iconic area. This drop zone, Scadder and Pura Brava behind us, has been going for about 30 years now. 1985 it started. How many years ago is that? 85?
Oh, don't tell me, Regan.
95, 2005, 15, 34 years.
Very, very good maths there from Regan Tetlow.
I'll tell you another little fact about Pura Brava.
Go on.
It's the same age as me. It's the whole marina was built 39 years ago. Actually, it's a little bit more, but it actually is.
Oh, really?
51 years ago, yeah. In 1967, the marina behind us opened. It was all marshland, as far as the eye could see. In Catalan, they call it Aguamolls, which means water land, and it is still called Aguamolls now. And they had an initiative in the mid-60s from some German developers to put in what they were going to call a Venice of the North, a Miami of Europe.
Ah, that makes sense. Hence all the canals.
Oh, it's all the canals. And I think it's about 50 kilometers of navigable canals which built up and created this beautiful marina they've got. And for some reason, they decided to put a runway right at the end of the marina. And so that runway was there for people who wanted to fly their planes in. And somebody spotted an opportunity to start a parachuting operation, which they did in the end of the 70s. And then in the 80s, then it started up as a commercial operation. And here we are now with Scadder and Pura Brava. And we're going back to the action. Emily King is ready for her second attempt, Emma.
Come on, Emily. Again, there is so much support coming through for Emily on Facebook. Mac McKenney, go Emily. Good luck from all the Driven to Extremes team. Let's see, Pete Haynes. Good luck, Ems. And she is in. Looking even more confident this time. Those words from Coach Zach must have worked. Into the head-up breaker. So Emily having extra things to deal with here. Thomas Flair. And that looked like the barrel roll. Lovely flying from Emily. So now having the chance to finish off the compulsories. This was a round where she had to get out last time. And a nice exit from Emily King. Huge support for this girl, this 10-year-old from iFly.
Yeah, lots of people shouting up for Mac McKenney, James Arnold, Harry Marshall, Chantel Pierce, all saying, come on, Emily, go strong.
That was really nice. Looked like her barrel may have been slightly off-heading. But she really did well on that compulsory. This is her first big international competition. She was here watching at Wind Games last year. Up next, Kai Minajima Lee, age 9 from Singapore.
Good morning, Singapore!
Moshi Won about to show us what he's got for his compulsories. I saw a little bit of Kai's training for compulsories. And we're in for a treat.
I think we should have mushy numbers as well.
I do. Should we be mushy 3 and 4?
Let's do it.
We need t-shirts, Regan. Or maybe white suits. Nice head-up breaker from Kai. This 9-year-old makes every move look incredible. Into his barrel roll stall. Very smooth flight from Kai. And exiting the door. Got a little bit stuck in the door, but he's got to be pleased with that.
Beautiful flight, incredible skill. 9 years of age, as good as it gets, really.
Absolutely. Up next is our youngest competitor, Emil from China, age only 7 years old. We saw a stunning free routine from him yesterday where he started, do you remember, Regan, with one leg up in the door?
Yeah, and finished like that as well. It was poetry in motion. It is. What we're seeing is just class. China, Nihong.
Nice. Straight into a head up split. Spin. Into barrel. Nice little breaker there. Into the Thomas Flair. Finishing head down. Beautiful side flying from Emil, age 7 from China. So much support here in the tunnel. Into his head up breaker. Very, very, very nicely executed from Emil. Well done.
Fantastic, stunning performance there from the 7-year-old. That incredible, sublime side flying hand down straight through the center of the tunnel. Beautiful stuff.
Okay, up next we have got Sydney Kennett from the USA, age 12. This is junior freestyle. This is compulsory 2, which is the third round that we've seen. We have one more round from them today, which is their free routine.
Good morning, USA!
Sydney is ready to fly. She's got the okay. Oh, there's a belated.
That was a bit delayed. Delayed reaction there. It is a long way to the States from here.
Wow, Sydney's flying is beautiful.
Nice.
These breakers are amazing. She's very, very creative with her routines. We've seen her flying in two-way dynamic. We've seen her flying in freestyle. Very exciting young flyer in Sydney Kennett. There is her barrel roll. That very straight, controlled body position into the head-up breaker. Very nicely executed. Look at that, Regan.
Beautiful, beautiful. Great control right in the center. Again, right in the center of the tunnel.
Very much on heading. So the judges are looking at that white line. You can see straight down. Whoa! Wow!
Yeah, that's her little signature
that
move.
That was amazing. Did her feet just touch her head?
Yeah.
Very, very nearly, if not. That was amazing.
Very reminiscent of Amy Watson with her move.
Yes, it was actually from her routine in Bahrain.
Very good morning. We're in the juniors right now with their second compulsory round. It's round 3 of the freestyle. After this, we're going into the open. Isabel Cole, Singapore, stretches and gets ready, Emma.
We are expecting to see some very flexible moves here. A lot of contortion. Isabel, she warms up. She's very, very flexible. Before flying, you can see her stretching and you just think, how can a body do that? But she is just a wonderful flyer. We're very excited. You can see her now. She's moving her hand, focusing hard. So what she's doing now is going through her routine in her head, visualizing what she's doing. A very mature skill for these young children to be doing. Visor down and she is in.
Great start.
Saw a stunning routine from Isabel yesterday. Look at that on heading. Beautiful barrel roll stall. Into a head up breaker. Nice control, Isabel.
Very smooth flying, isn't it? Very smooth.
Very smooth. She manages to make everything look graceful, Regan. Into the Thomas Flair. Again, very, very controlled. Finishing with a head down spin. And a really nice exit. Isabel, really well done.
Next up, we're moving on to Poland. Dzień dobry, Poland. Dzień dobry with Kinga Balor.
So Kinga currently leading the pack, currently up at the top of the scoreboard. very, very closely followed by Malachi. It's going to be a close battle between the two of them.
Just watching there, the previous, Caroline Teo says, go Izzy, Moshi 3. We can't be Moshi 3.
Oh my goodness. Okay, maybe we're Moshi 4 and 5.
Caroline, can you tell us what Moshi numbers me and Emma can have, please? Thank you.
Maybe we have to have our ages, Regan.
I definitely want a Moshi number.
I definitely want a Moshi number as well. Kinga in the door, she's ready. A very focused, very driven flyer. We've seen Brother Tomek competing in solo speed. Kinga is in. She has improved hugely since last time we've seen her fly. Thomas Flair.
Straight out the door.
Into head up breaker. Wow, that was a very nicely linked move.
Wow.
Look at that breaker. See, she's straight down that center line for her barrel roll. Whoa, Kinga. You can see why she is at the top of the table right now.
And out she goes, bringing those breakers to the shores. Wow.
She makes it look so, so, so easy. Here now is Evelina Kalugina from Russia. Hear a big round of applause out in the crowd.
So I've just been told by Caroline, we're still looking for a Moshi 4 in Singapore, so there can be a four-way team, so you two can be 5 and 6. Do you want to be 5?
I'll be 5.
I'll be Moshi 6.
Oh, brilliant. We're Moshis. We're officially Moshis.
Yes.
Should we do a two-way team next year,
Let's
Regan?
Do it. On our bellies, of course. And Russia, 14, Evelina is next.
Slight wobble into the door. Beautiful head-up splits there. You can see she is right down that center line for her barrel roll stall. Saw Evelina competing in the World Cup last year. Again, her flying is just getting stronger and stronger. Thomas Flair. Seen some lovely moves here. Nicely linked from Evelina. And she's out.
I like that nice 180 through the door as well.
That was very nice.
Very nice indeed. It's Wing Games and it's the 2019 edition. It's the sixth time we've had this event. All started in 2014 with this beautiful location. Imperia Brava, it's hashtag more than a tunnel and it's hashtag the Wing Games 2019. Emma, we've just seen there the juniors with their compulsories, but we still got Sophia and Malachi to come.
So Sophia had that beautiful free routine that we saw yesterday. Very delicate, very graceful. She had a big smile on her face. She looked so, so relaxed competing here.
It's a beautiful free round. And it's China and Sophia.
Nice, Thomas Flair ending head down. Mixed in with some lovely side flying. Barrel roll stall. Such a skilled young flyer here. Head up breaker, beginning head up, ending head up. And she's out of the tunnel. Sophia from China.
Yeah, beautiful, great to see. So tiny, the helmet looks incredibly big, doesn't it?
She's very cute, Regan.
She is indeed. Still to come, he was sick yesterday. Still looks a bit grey and pallid in his complexion, but he was flying hard yesterday as well, even with not feeling on top form.
Yes, he was. Great free routine, great song.
Yes.
It's Malachi, it's Chewy, age 14 from Canada. He is looking a bit better today. We've spoken to his mum and dad. They're here supporting him. I did notice dad was wearing flame shoes that match this suit, which are pretty amazing.
Absolutely it is. Fly the stash, here we go.
Very creative flyer, very, very strong. He always shows us something unique. Head at Breaker. He is just 0.3 behind Kinga on the scoreboard at the moment, but things could change after this compulsory round. Very nice barrel stall. Very much on heading. Throwing in some breakers there.
Monica Holland Husbo says, go Molokai, with the Canadian flag and the Norwegian flag next to them. Interesting.
Very nice. Thomas Flair completed that. It's the three compulsory moves completed. Malachi's out of the tunnel. He's absolutely smashed it despite being ill.
Yeah, brilliant stuff there from all our freestyle juniors. And when we say juniors, we're just talking about the age. It's nothing to do with skill level.
No, it's not, Regan. We are seeing some very, very high skill level here. I can't believe what we've seen.
When we're going into the open category next, is it the same routines or is it a different draw?
Yeah, so it will be the same compulsory moves, again, linked by choice, however the performer chooses to link the moves. But again, they can do them in any order. But the judges do score, so when we see the scores, we will see the scores in a particular order, which I will tell you about in a moment.
And after that, we're going to be going into the final live judging of VFS and into the final live judging of AirFest. We'll be back in the studio with Moshi 5 and 6 very shortly. See you then.
February.